Golgotha on the outskirts of town. They're nailed to a rugged cross as his mockers gathered round. The sky spoke like thunder when he finally bowed his head. He who had given life now hung there dead. Then his mother and some friends came to carry him away. They were trying to speak through a broken heart, what only tears could say. The sunset cast no shadow on the world's darkest day, and with one last look they laid him in the grave.
But I talked to him today, and my cares all fell away. He made me feel like life had just begun. He said all of my trials can be turned into triumphs through the victory that he's already won. Talked to him today, and the comfort that he gave filled me with desire to tell the world that on Calvary he died, but right now he is alive. I know because I talked to him today.
Mary Magdalene came breathless to the place where Peter lay. He was searching through his broken heart, trying to find the faith to pray. But as he heard her joyful story, his sorrow could not stay, and his hope sprang up through the words he heard her say. She said, I talked to him today, and my cares all fell away. Like life had just begun. He said all of my trials can be turned into triumphs through the victory that he's already won. And I talked to him today, and the comfort that he gave filled me with desire to tell the world. I talked to him today. That on Calvary he died, but right now he is alive. I know because I talked to him today.
To begin this church service, we're going to start by singing God Lead Us Along on page 298. Page 298, God Lead Us Along.
Some through the flood, some through the Dear Father, Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for the liberty, the freedom. I'm so proud to gather in your house to hear your word openly. Lord, I just pray you just be with the giver and to furtherance of this ministry and those that are not here. For what reason and what cause, Lord, you know their hearts. And just bless us as we prepare for the preaching of your word. Fill us with your spirit. And just bless the giver also. Thank you. Ask for Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Now let's sing on page 70, Holy, Holy, Holy. Verses 1, 2, and 4. Holy, Holy, Holy on page 70. Page 70 in the dark blue songbook. Holy, holy, holy.
Holy, holy, holy. Church cleaning on the sign up sheet. Please have a clean person you sign up for. Continue reading daily in Ephesians. Read verse by verse for understanding. Pray for all church members and their families. Recovery of those dealing with sickness. United States, Arizona, Navajo Nation leaders. Pray for the revival of our country during this time of opportunity to be helping witness to someone else. Birthdays this week is Raymond on the 21st. Or next week. Or 2 weeks. Now we're on page 308, Higher Ground. Okay.
Amen. It's good to be in church. All right, we'll go ahead and open our Bibles back in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10 through 13. The day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, the earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness, looking for and hastening unto the coming of the day of God, wherein heavens, being on fire, shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and a new earth, wherein dwelleth righteousness. Our Heavenly Father, again, we thank you for your word. We do pray you would bless our hearts again this morning by your Spirit as we go through the scriptures, help us to understand something that will help us to be what we need to be. So bless us this morning. Thank you for the listeners, and thank you for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's been good. My title is The Decisions. Decisions. That's what he's saying. What manner of persons are ye to be in all holy conversation and godliness? And then the word repentance at the end of verse number 9. But that all should come to repentance. There are decisions that should be made. And don't lose it, because in our time, people are passing away. Those that we know pretty close are suddenly off the scene. Some not so old, but maybe some with diseases and accidents and so forth. So you can't say, I'm going to live tomorrow. James does say, boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day will bring forth. And so this morning we have a decision before us. You know, if you have rejected repentance to life, you have just rejected the most important thing that God has, that is grace and mercy, or mercy and grace. If we put it in order, it's mercy, and then you can have grace also. And so that's the decision that are ever before us, every day. And we don't want to lose the sight of our Savior. Look at the verse in verse number 12. He says, looking for and hastening unto the coming of the day of God. We ought to be looking. Looking doesn't mean that you're actually looking at the skies and see if some clouds are forming. Actually, it means your personal godliness, how you face each day, how you walk, how you're going to make use of your day. That's how, just like Luke said, occupy till I come, till he come. You know, occupying is like a waiter. A waiter or a waitress are not just waiting, they will be busy moving about. That's what we are. And so here in our reading, the decision of rejection is what we're going to look at first. Verse number 9, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but all, that all should come to repentance. In these readings, I notice that it's hidden and those that don't believe him and those that believe him. Most of the time it's the same, like repentance is for the unsaved first. And then for us believers, we still have to have a repentant heart in order to grow. And then we're looking, we know that the earth will not be destroyed, heavens are going to be remade, and we were looking for that. And so in that space of time, where we're actually doing something, we're actually changing, we're actually being a different person as we look at that. So it actually covers both like judgment. You'll be talking about the great white throne judgment and then judgment seat of Christ. And those are two different scenes and two different places. And he's always seen both sometimes at the same time. And so in verse 10 it says, but the day of the Lord, that can be understood to mean several ways are being interpreted. Some say it begins at the rapture. Some say it begins at the coming of the Lord to reign on earth. And then some say it's the end, when everything is destroyed. And so whatever way you get it, I believe it has to, we can cover all those three areas in one shot. And so he's coming. And you know, a thief is that you don't know when that person is coming and they're oh, got to get out. You're always on alert on what you have, yeah. And you know, I used to have a gas can full of gas, and it was sitting under a tree by my trailer. I always knew it was there. And then one day were away, he came back. I noticed a gas can was missing. And so somebody came when we were not there, took away the gas can full of gas, yeah. And whoever needed it probably took it and never gave the container back. But that's the thief will come take away your stuff like through yourself, yeah. are scammed by the Hanaya. Some of those scammers are thieves. They want to take your name, they want to take your account, they want to take your social security number. You know, that's the way with the world are full of thieves. And so if you understand that, you know, the Lord, when he comes, he's not going to blow his horn at the coming of the rapture. He's going to just come all suddenly. And Revelation chapter 1 says they will behold him. They're actually going to see him appear in person. They're going to look at him and say, that's him. That's the one we didn't want. That's the person that's supposed to be Lord of our lives. And they're going to see that. And that's he's coming. He's going to come. And then the earth, it says, is going to be burned up. It says with heavens, those that were heavens, not just one heaven, but heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. What heat is so strong? And that's the kind of heat the earth also and the works there that are therein shall be burned up. You know, earth is something that we enjoy. We can enjoy this earth, live a life to the fullest, but we need to have a spiritual foresight too. We need to go beyond what we have, go beyond how much blessing that we can receive. We need to see the Lord himself. And that's why if we're just looking down all the time and then go to heaven, everything that we rest our whole being on will be gone. Notice it says all things in verse 11, seeing that then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of person are ye to be in all holy conversation? Conversation is another word for behavior. Your character and godliness. Yeah. So it's important that we live for the Lord. Jesus so on shall how that so it at the last has in za so it all this so a call even get the hala na so 11 ke no to the art so art so na so he in the to he ho hat e go shin na to this sa de ti ge no in nan je ne la Out of Jota, I know in none again. You know, things that we see are going to be gone. Notice in Mark 8:36, it makes a statement about us, it says, for what shall a man, shall it profit a man or a person if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? You know, your soul is worth more than anything in this world. If we gain everything and lose it all, you just have lost the most important thing that you wish to have in heaven, yeah.
Right.
You stay in the yard or listen. You know, that's something. You know, that's always the direction that the Lord was referring to in his preaching and teaching, as Luke 12 and verse number 19 up to 20. And it's a story that begins a little bit earlier than that. And the person was making some progress in his life, making some success, probably banking some money, store some things, and then he actually redid all of that, and then here the Lord said, and I will say to that, to my soul, you know, this person is talking to himself, soul, thou hast much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? You know, that's a good question. We can just have something in our grip and then lose it, yeah?
Right.
You know, the decision that you have, that you make, is yours. It's not God's. God already did the hard part. And yours is the easy part. Just believe. What a simple thing that you can do. That he died, he rose again for you to save your soul. If we just can't believe that, he'll save you. And so simple, yet we are chasing something in this world, yeah. Chasing a bubble that will burst and then it'll be gone, yeah. Isaiah chapter 34 and verse 3 and 4. Their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come up out of their carcasses, and the mountains shall be melted with blood, and all the hosts of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, yeah. You know, you fold up something like that. It's not there anymore. So, you know, the heaven is going to just, God's going to fold it up because he's the creator of it. And all of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, and all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth off on the vine, and as a falling fig on the fig tree. Nearly, you know that if something is ripe, it's just going to drop, yeah. And there's a friend that lives down by the gap, on the other side, actually on our side, Hidden Spring. He said he grows peaches and apples, and then every summer, he says, when they get ripe, they'll just begin to drop, he said. Yeah, he gave me some. He said, it's available, you can come and pick. And after they drop, it's just a waste. And they probably has an orchard full of fruit trees. And that's the way things are, you know, things fall. When God says so, you know, it's going to end. That's going to be the end of it. And that's human life, yeah. And we try to treasure this life. Go to Revelation 20 and verse number 11. And there, you know, there's some verses that we wish that were not there, yeah. Human thinking. There are verses that we wish was not there in our reading. But that's what God gives us. And verse 11, 2011. And I saw a great white throne. A yod egos, sekaigo kadon huitahi isana, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. You know, he's the creator of it all. So when he says disappear, they will disappear. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. In other words, those that you know are dead, then trust the Lord, come back, stand before God, resurrected to be judged. And the books were opened, probably a book of your defense, yeah. Whatever plea you want to plead, there in that book. Because I was a good man, because I was generous, I was a church goer, I prayed, and anything. Minus trusting the Lord. Just being good. You'll say it's always in the books. They're in the books. And another book, singular, and that's the one that my name is written, and I hope yours too, if you're saved. Book of Life, which is the Book of Life, and the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, plural, according to their works. How good are you? What can you say that declares you right with God? That's why you're going to have it in that, those books. Verse 13, and the sea gave up the dead which were in it, death and hell, deliver up the dead which were in them. It's just like, you know, I go to Tuba City, and I sit in those places, you know, the jail. That's where they're being held. You know, I miss one inmate. And I say, where is so-and-so? And they said he went to a higher place. You know, what they were saying is that he went to a federal institution. So, you know, those people are just waiting for their final verdict. Of course, they're delivered up from hell, which, what did it say? Hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged, every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. You know, that is, in a way, we're born once, die twice. Or we're born again, twice, and die once. Physical death, we'll go to heaven. And so that is available to us. So if you didn't trust him, you're going to actually die again. Verse 150, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. That's their final resting place. If that is so, you know, why not just say, hey, I'll just get saved. Let me just trust you to save me from this eternal punishment. And then I have Psalm 50, verse 3 and 4. To be writing down the verses. Then I have Micah chapter 1 and verse 4. And those are, has to do with just the outcome, a very set outcome that this world that we believe is ours. We claim this earth, yeah. We fence our land. And then we say, this is mine, this is, everything is mine. And then, you know, that's going to be gone. A 4-second bond won't help. And I would say that's our boundary. You know, make heaven your boundary. It'll be good. Trust him and get saved. And then the second is the decision of repentance. And that is for those that don't believe need to just repent of their unbelief and turn to belief. For us that are saved, we have a lot of repenting I'm thinking about a verse that I'm going to read a little bit later, already ahead of it. But anyway, maybe I didn't write it down because it doesn't look that way. I think it's 2 Corinthians 7:10. It says, for godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation. This is talking to Christians, so Christians are already saved. Salvation is probably from yourself, your coldness, your unbelief, your losing of love for the Lord, all of that. You can be delivered again from that here. Not necessarily getting saved again, but just being free. Godly sorrow, if you really mean what you say and pray, then God can help you change. Not to be repented of, but godly sorrow of the world worketh death. You know, people are having heart attack because they're worried about something. They're dying because they're losing something. Their focus is wrong. So that's why they're all dying. Yeah, these days, even young people die because they're worried about something. Heart attacks, Alright, let's see. And our God, or Jesus, uses willing Christians to the repentance by Yeshua. God or Jesus uses willing Christians. In Israel, or Atlanta, Israel. You know, I gave a testimony several times about the time I surrendered to the Lord fully. Walking with the Lord. It's reasonable if you can just give it to Him. Verse number 2, and be not conformed to this world. You know, that's easy to do, yeah. You know, in the world of ours, and even in a Christian world, we're trying to copy what the world is doing. That's where your Christian rock comes in, yeah. Mm-hmm. You're trying to copy the world. You know, the world is not Christian. So Christian can't be a rock. Mm-hmm. The only rock that you mentioned, the rock is Jesus. I think it's number. You know, the Lord is our rock, you see. Not the kind of bang stuff, but He is the, your solid state, solid position. And that's the rock you have. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Huh. You know, if you give yourself to Him, Let Him take care of you. You will be changing. Your mind are going to think like His. That ye may prove what is that good, acceptable,
yeah,
and perfect will of God. Yeah. If you just give yourself to Him, even if you do every day, because the Bible does say, take up your cross daily, dear. Mm-hmm. So even in our earlier, in Sunday school, our bodies are in, our inner man is renewed day by day. Yeah. So if we can just do daily, that should be good. Just say, Lord, help me today. I like to go there. I have plans to even go to the hospital. Just say, hey, I need some protection. I need some help. And you know, you'll see things turn out right. And whatever you do, it can be good. You can appreciate the Lord in your just activities. If you give it to Him, you'll enjoy it. You know Him. Yeah, just enough. So without, so I saw it had issue bonds, right? Jesus, I don't know. It's still going to be happening. We can have victories. It's good. And then, under that decision of repentance, look at verse number 13. 2 Peter 3:13. Nevertheless, we, plural, according to His promise, you know, the promise is unshakable. According to His promise, look for new heavens and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness. Neither. That's right. If Jesus comes today, there'll be 1,007 years. That's where a new earth is going to be made. That's where a new heaven is going to be. And there's going to be no more sin, yeah. After the great white throne judgment, no more sin. So we have a new earth, new heavens, and no sinners are going to be there. They're going to be all gone. We wouldn't know how to sin. We'll be perfect again, like when Adam and Eve were created, they were perfect. And that's how it's going to be when all is done, when His work is all complete. So, have you looked lately? Asa Ndetki, even out of ignorance, we might look at the clouds, yeah. If you have a whole lot of people in white congregate together, it's going to be like a cloud, yeah. It's like, I'm going to have that every day, yeah. A sahali, yeah. When the Lord is not, of course, not a lot of high stuff, all day. When He comes, it's going to be like that. And so, in our ignorance, we can look at the clouds, it might look like, you know, some even say that it looks like Jesus. And maybe I haven't seen a cloud that looks like, I don't know what Jesus looks like. Even the guy that thinks he drew the picture of Jesus doesn't even know what Jesus looks like. He doesn't have long hair, he doesn't have blue eyes. Mm-hmm. And I don't think he has white skin. But, you know, human imaginations can cause a lot of confusion, yeah. And so, hey, when he comes, we're going to see him as he is in the Bible. So, what are we doing here? We're trying to get ready to go to heaven. Mine is a little bit closer than yours, yeah. I'm getting ready. I think I'm almost ready. I'd like to be more than ready. I'd like to cover all grounds. Titus 2:12 and verse 13. Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly. I don't let by the sister kids over there. Should I go left? Should I go right? Should I stop? Should I go? Should I speed up? Should I slow down? Should I look up? Should I look ahead? Should I listen? You know, soberly means that you're using all your senses, yeah? Use it for good. Righteously and godly in this present world. Cut right here. Practice that. Practical, isn't it? Practical life starts here. Verse 13, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. He's coming. So that's why we're trying to be the best that we can be at His appearing. We're getting ready. And even Dawi Tathya, that's why we sing. So the practical side of things, verse 14, back at 2 Peter. Wherefore, Nina, or therefore, Eitma, Yon Hosh Nini, what out Bakun Zidun Son, seeing that you look for such things, be diligent that ye may be found of Him. In peace, without spot, and blameless, Nina. That means clean, clean, clean life. While we are still here, practical life to be found in Him. Go to Philippians 1:27. Philippians 1:27. Only let your conversation or conduct behavior be as it becometh the gospel of Christ, that whether I come and see you, or else be absent, I will hear of your affair, that ye stand fast in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the faith of the gospel. Neither. We're all looking the same direction. We're all looking for the same thing. We all have the same purpose. And we're looking for His coming. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse number 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse number 2. And that's probably the verse you know, maybe. For ye are our epistle, Paul said, our letter. Ye are our letters written in our hearts and known and read of all men. And of the Christians that are in church today, they go back to their normal lifestyle. They are the representative of the preacher or the church that they belong to. They are being read by somebody. You know, yesterday somebody, when I tried to pick up the mail, somebody approached me and said, would you help me? No, I'm thinking money. And the person said, would you pray for me? And I said, I don't know you. And the person said, you know me. So they know us, yeah. Pray for me, Donna. So I prayed. If that's all they need, that I can give that. We're read by all men, yeah. There's hope in these people, yeah. And then I had a chance to offer the person that, you know. You go to church, I said, and then the person said, only when I am hurting. You know, the unsaved know that when they're hurting, they can be near you. Only when I'm hurting. And so yesterday was the day this person was hurting. And so that's just my understanding what's going on with a person. James 3:13. Who is wise? I wonder if I got the right verse. And endure with knowledge money, let him show out a good conversation. Okay, there it is again. Conversation is conduct, character, his works with meekness and wisdom. Meekness and wisdom. So what do you do? Conveys you to another person, yeah. And it helps them. And you are a Christian. And let's go to Hebrew chapter 12. I'm on approaching the landing strip. Whose voice then shook the earth, now? But now he had promised, saying, yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also heaven. And this word, yet once more, signify the removing of those things that are shaken as of things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. Wherefore we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace whereby we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. For God is a consuming fire. You know, there are things that can be shaken, yeah. Come to think of it, you know, there are some things that can be shaken. Paul said in Timothy that you're soon shaken in Old Thessalonians, I think. Soon shaken in mind. People can be shaken in the mind. Go the wrong way, yeah. But you know, my salvation cannot be shaken, yeah. It's secure. You can't shake it. Shoot it. Hit it. Whatever you want to do to the devil, it won't be shaken because my Savior died and rose again, and that's why I have my salvation. My name is written in the book of life. That can't be shaken. And there are some other things that can't be shaken. So, you know, at the judgment seat of Christ, our works are going to be judged. Some of the Christians are going to be maybe superficial, artificial, hypocritical, and playing along the game of Christianity and act like they're involved when they get to heaven. It says some of those will be burnt up. So it's going to just open before us, yeah. How good we were by what we did. That we were we serious with the truth? Did we really mean business when we did those things? And that will show up. And so we want what can't be shaken, yeah. Seriousness. Be true. Walk with the Lord. And love Him honestly and serve Him. Let's pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you for the hour. Thank you that you can bless us again this morning. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's end this church series by singing on page 258. He hideth his soul. Page 258, he hideth my soul in the dark blue songbook and the light red songbook. Page 258. The dark blue songbook and the light red songbook.
A wonderful Savior is Jesus my Lord. A wonderful Savior to me. He hides my soul in the cleft of the rock. Where I see.
Christian.
Amen.